So why did a chicken cross the road? Now, when you hear that, you start thinking about the possible answers and the possible punchlines, and you start thinking about what could be funny. That is what I'm interested in. Which parts of the brain are more likely to predict how well you're going to remember that joke? Which parts of the brain are more likely to tell us how effective that joke was? So we were able to find that there are certain brain regions which could predict how well you're able to remember information from a humorous message as compared to a non-humorous message. Now, this really helps us tease out how the brain is responding to jokes and what are the psychological processes which underlie the processing of humor. By looking at the brain activations, we can actually see how the brain is processing these jokes and how the brain is then getting rewarded or not rewarded in response to these jokes, and which can really make us understand what are the implications of these jokes and how we can come up with better communication strategies to bridge gaps. The next step for my research is to test these same findings in India. I want to understand humor in a more global fashion, not just because I think there are some universal aspects of humor, because everyone laughs, but I also think that there are some very critical cultural aspects of it, which is why everyone laughs at different things. So in my research, I focus on how we perceive comedy and we perceive humor. And that also made me interested in how we generate comedy. I take classes in improv at Comedy Sports Philadelphia. I've been doing that for a year now. I used to do theater back in my undergrad. And I thought improv might be a good stepping stone to perform comedy and to understand the skill sets that go into getting a belly laugh from the audience. I did my undergraduate studies in computer science and engineering at IIIT Delhi, India. I used to work in an image analysis and biometrics lab where I used to do machine learning and pattern recognition algorithms on face recognition primarily. So here I was interested in social sciences and neuroscience. So I was just Googling media, social science, communication, and first name that popped up was Emily B. Falk. I immediately went through the whole lab website, I went through Annenberg's website, and I was like, wow, this is almost exactly what I was looking for. And the first thing I did was I filled up my application packet, and here I am. I had very little confidence because I was from a computer science background, and I felt like, oh, people applying there are from a more humanities, social science kind of background, and I won't really fit in. And nothing could be farther from truth in terms of fitting in, because I think people over here are from a variety of backgrounds, technical and non-technical, and they are all using their backgrounds in a variety of really innovative ways. It's really exciting to talk to my peers who are from a really rich and diverse set of backgrounds.